All right. Welcome back, everybody. This is XCOM Quest for Victory, Season 7. We are back from our first mission. I think it was Hidden Skull. If I recall correctly, we have some promotions to give out. We have, who is it? 321 Nick and Splattercat have both requested these gunners. Now, who they get, they didn't say. They just wanted a specific gunner. So, I'm gonna say, we're gonna go Splattercat with Affendivia. This will be Splattercat. Good. All around good. So we're gonna go ahead and promote Splattercat. Sorry, I'm kinda not. Splattercat. Okay, no, you're good. Splattercat's gonna have a gunner. We're also going to have the other individual. This is going to be now Nick. I wish you got health. We'll deal with that in the due time. This is gonna be last name. Sympathizer. The Sympathizer. Always a great name on Nick. No one else has requested any other soldiers. So no. We have one. One is a guaranteed. And that person is you, Perez. You are already guaranteed to somebody from my recollection. Right? Right? Because you're Bouncer, you're Belmont, yeah. You are guaranteed to somebody. Because you're the medic. No. No. Yes. Yeah, you're the medic. You're the medic, and you are going to be Primus. Goodwill. Not goodwill. Sort of not goodwill. I'm not very happy with your will promotions, but, you know, not much we can do about that. Laniston. DeJennifer. And Primus. Everybody else is going to be a run of the mill, and you're my infantry. You're my... Yeah. You are my infantry. Good, and you're gonna be my standard Overwatch, covering fire. Opportunist. I will go in, I keep on forgetting that this isn't the normal. I will go into detail as to who I'm picking and why. Promote, just random. Drizzle. Drizz. The Omega, the Omega Drizz. You are going to be our scout. Boink. Yay, good, 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 just all good. Still good. Still good, I love it. We're also gonna have a new random promotion. 55 Hobos. Last name is gonna be 55 Hobos, there we go, Walker. Great name, too. Alright, which leaves Patterson, who's going to be the other medic, from my recollection. Good. All good. You are going to be a random. Foxy. Pirate. Foxy. Good. All well and good. We have our last two gunners here. Are going to be, make sure the camera's all good now. Good. Wish you would guys would get some health, but this is a scenario of beggars can't be choosers. Plexico. Flex. And the last one. Where are you? There you are. Good. All around good. So, nope. You're already reserved for somebody. Wet night. Night wet pinky once you get there. All right. Those are the promotions. All right. I don't think I ever went into detail about choices and why I made them for cadre. So cadre, I look for what I like to call babysitters. And my babysitters are infantry, gunners, scouts, and medics. Now, I've come to find that certain soldiers actually play better together than others. A good example would be a gunner infantry. Those generally work out pretty well. A counterexample is a scout medic. Those work out pretty well. Gunner can go with anybody pretty much. Medic can go with anybody pretty much. Gunner medics are pretty good. Scout infantry, though, is odd. That's the only odd pairing that I would say. But for the most part, those four can babysit a squad more or less on their own. They don't need much interaction from anybody else. And the reason is most of their, with the exclusion of the infantry, most of their, the medics, gunners, and scouts' abilities are to remove overwatch. With the scout running and the gunner and the medic doing what they need to do. The only reason I say that scout and in infantry don't work out that well, in my opinion, is that with the cadre bonus, at being at corporal, you don't have suppression available to you, which you could arguably take later on down the line. I'm still going to take Deadeye eventually, because flyers are just non-stop in this game, so I prefer Deadeye on all my infantry. But you could arguably take suppression. From there, you could then overwatch, yada, yada, yada. But suppression is just far too strong. It's so strong, I do my gunner mission first. Generally, I always do my gunner mission first to roll that just as quickly as possible and have suppression always available to me. Yeah, I'm probably going to have to run someone fatigue because when we hit the big button, I'm 90% sure something is going to pop up. But at the same time, it's just how this one's going to play out. It's just how the campaign plays. So, you know, it's that my cadres are my scouts, infantry, medics, and gunners, and they can pretty much babysit all the PFCs up to who they need. And the goal is not to always do specific, I default to it, but it's bad practice. Normally the better practice would be to have a general composition of a squad to say, okay, I need, like right now, what I would say is I need at least a rocketeer, an engineer, and an assault on the next mission, and then I can take one of whatever I need most next. But in reality, what's probably going to happen is I'm going to go, okay, and I say it's a bad habit, but I'm babysitting in the first month. More or less, you tactically shouldn't encounter anything that you're out of league with. It's going to be drones, like, with the exclusion of a large landed or a small landed or anything landed. You're not going to meet anything that's going to surprise you other than sectoids and drones. So your babysitters need to be able to deal with sectoids and drones the most. With sectoids being able to overwatch and drones derping from suppression, gunners are, in my opinion, my natural first go-to. I need you ASAP. Excuse me. I need you ASAP and I need you set up immediately to handle all whatever I'm going to see in the next month. I will almost always... Not almost always. Unless all of my gunners are injured, I will always take a gunner. I value them that much early on. Early on, they are that valuable. Even later on, they're valuable. But early on, they are that valuable. Every squad has a gunner. And for me, generally, every squad also has a scout. Those are kind of my go-to. So naturally, my next training mission, in all likelihood, is going to be a sniper-scout mixture. With 55 hobos already being up and running, it may be not a scout mixture, depending on who else I take. If I take Hobo, then I'm going to bring in another scout. But if I don't, I may just do a half and half of sniper scouts just to get the numbers up. And then from there, I'm going to roll with that. Driz, and I'll probably have a medic paired on the next one later on, probably Foxy, just to get Foxy going. Is everybody good in the health department? Pretty much. Bounce Trees being a boss, so is Splattercat, but other and Wet Knight, but other than the and I already said Splattercat, but other than that, we're pretty much good. Belmont's doing good on her own, if I recall correctly. Yes. I need to figure out who's gonna be my other sniper. It's part of a tradition from Twitch chat. Not you. I mean, you could, but not you. You. But you won't be it. Where is... Where are you? I just passed you. Wow, I don't think I have any... There we go. That's one. There we go. That'll be the person. That'll be the thing. Sorry. Dreadnought, or Sacred Asakura, always gets a sniper. It's just tradition now. It's more or less, that's just it. That's tradition. We are still rolling on Xenobiology. After this, we're going to go into Alien Materials, and once Xenobiology's done, I will go into a detailed, basically explanation of what the research path is and why I have chosen that path specifically. We're still excavating over to our OTS to be ready to build that when need be. Other than that, we're kind of just chilling out. Laboratory's being built, uplink's doing whatever. Barracks is already promoted, aircraft that's still wrecked.
Satellite uplink.
Everything else is
capacity.
Fine in terms of
additional
panic.
Uplink required.
Yes, now we're more or less just waiting for that first country to pop out. Which is only, are we building anything? Nope, no projects. Should we be building anything? No, I already have two of those, nine of those. We could arguably build a SHIV. But I have no need for it right now. We're not in any fatigue spiral of sorts. I'm not going to take a SHIV no matter what, unless it is a large landed. Even then, you could justify it. A SHIV would not be a bad investment. Maybe not the wisest investment. No, a SHIV would be a bad investment. Tying up that $60 is not, $60 is not a lot. I mean, it's a good amount, but that is much more valuable early on in other aspects, even if you just save it for the end of the month. So we're gonna keep it. We're gonna go ahead. Yeah, we're good. We're good. Like in the hood. No, stop it, you dummy! Hit the big button. Play the globe. Play the globe. Roll the dice. Play the cards down. Go all in. Give me a mission. We are very good.
Commander,
abduction. Moderate abduction. Now,
requests for assistance. Abductions in progress.
For those unaware, this is an indicator of how many pods you're going to get. And you will commonly hear me say, oh, we're being underpaid today or we're being overpaid today. What this indicates is the number of pods active on the map that you're going to. And it's a plus or minus one system. So it starts from 2 to 5. Being light at 2, moderate at 3, heavy at 4, swarming at 5. This first mission is a minus 1. The first mission, from my recollection, is almost always a heavy mission. So I wager this time we're being underpaid just a little bit. With that notion in mind, we still have 8 hours. Is anybody out in 8 hours of fatigue? Always good to check. We have one day on Bouncer Tree, so no, we're gonna have to run some fatigues. Which is fine, we can get a rookie training mission going in. Question is, where is the map and who are we gonna train? It's an urban block. Now, urban blocks are... eventually you will start to learn what types of maps these are. You're still gonna probably need a reference material. But you will start to learn what they are. This is the truck stop, the slaughterhouse, portent map, the meld tutorial with the cow. You have the convenience store, which I like. Compounding light, which I have yet to get an abduction on that, but that'd be interesting. You have the commercial street, which I am terrified of. You have the restaurant. Another commercial alley, bit different. And that's it. That's it. Those are actually pretty good maps. I'm fairly fluent in all those maps. I'm confident we can take. So who do we take? Well, this so much isn't a go get them map. This is more of a firing from where we are and dealing with it. So this is going to be not so much a scout map. This is going to be a Driz map. And infantry is going to be very strong here, especially considering I don't want to be moving a lot, I want to be just focusing down targets specifically. And using rookies as pseudo grenadiers to remove cover. So, first things first, we're going to have to grab a gunner. Also, generally on these maps, you can do a rooftop strategy, which always is bonus to us. And Overwatch infantry is going to be tremendously phenomenal at that point. While it is tempting to take two corporals, I think that would be a bad move. A, he would be out for on fatigue damage for a while. But B, I would like to spread out the experience, not to just my corporals. My first instinct is to go, okay, take the corporals, make it as safe a mission as possible. But that's not the wisest move in all honesty. The wiser move is to take one of our buddies down here, get them ready to promote on the next mission so that by the end of the month they will at least be Lance Corporals and have holo targeting, which is huge when it starts being floaters next month. Floaters and thin men and seekers and just all this mayhem. The holo targeting you gain from suppression and or shooting at a target is huge in terms of just squad effectiveness. Plus 10 aim across squad on a single target can get a more or less kind of guarantee you that target, or it just may land you that critical hit as you need it in that specific moment. A gunner with holo targeting is huge, and they don't get that until Lance Corporal, so we need to roll somebody into Lance Corporal. With that being said, and while we're taking a corporal on this type of mission, I think Splattercat with the negative defense, higher aim, we're going to probably be doing a lot of overwatching. That aim's going to help more than every other gunner. The suppression may not be as useful per se, but at the same time, we're going to need it. And we also don't want to be moving as much. So Splattercat with 11 mobility may be a saw gunner, just so that we're not logged down with an LMG. But that mobility penalty would be much, 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 much worse. So we're going to go ahead. No, we're not. Yes, we are. No, we're not. Yes, we are. Splattercat's going to be the go-to for the gunner. I'm still debating if that mobility's okay. Let's go ahead and outfit you standard gunner style with a saw and see what we get. We have 9 mobility. What does an LMG give you? 8 mobility. We gain squad sight. We gain the ability to move and shoot. We're not going to be moving and shooting much anyways, and we're going to be pretty stagnant. So we're going to go ahead and go the LMG. You're pretty much going to have to yellow move to blue move with the squad, which is fine. You have to yellow move anyways, and we're going to have to be covered bouncing if we're moving. That leaves us with Driz. Now, Driz being an Overwatch infantry, you will see me sometime in the campaign, and I will probably get into it when we start doing that. But you will see me taking battle rifles later on down the line, which battle rifles are great in the right hands. In an Overwatch infantry's hands, where opportunist and covering fire is more important, with battle rifle taking a negative 10 aim penalty after the first shot or after a blue move, I much rather prefer an assault rifle, an ability to either move in Overwatch and have no penalty or shoot in Overwatch and have no penalty in aim. The consistent damage application of an assault rifle to me is more valuable than the +1 damage aim of the battle rifle at this point in time. Now, we start rolling into some other missions with some different other x-rays. That's a different story. We can change things around. Again, we're trying to overwatch as much as possible. We're trying to do as much damage as possible. That means a laser sight and a high-capacity mags for our infantry. Those two together basically combine with the specific first perk of light 'em up into just shooting as many times as possible and not having to really worry about ammo count more than needed. The other bonus is as long as we are smart about watching our ammo, we can shoot and then reload and have a full mag for the next turn. The ability to shoot twice is pretty big, and especially with the squad that we're taking, with Splattercat being an LMG-er and having 8 mobility, god, that's terrible, we will be able to more or less sit in place and just force our force down their throats, and that's more or less the plan going to be with this one. Now, then the question becomes, who are we taking on this mission? What are we doing? Well, like I said, depending on who we take, we're going to basically do a scouting mission and or a sniper mission. Now, I would like one sniper. I'm gonna go 3 scouts. I would like to get to 4 scouts quickly. On top of the fact that I like my scouts getting, I'm not taking those, I'm just using an example. I like to get my scouts to here as quickly as possible. Concealment is, in my opinion, one of the most valuable perks in this game, the ability to basically have an infinite battle scanner, as long as you're smart about where you go, is huge. You can have a sniper in the backfield, scout up front, concealed. You can just start pegging away. As long as the scout's in the right position, they're not going to be flanked and exposed. You have that infinite battle scanner. X-rays don't know what to do. They're going to run around. You can just pick them off at long range, and then the scout can pop them from concealment with a crit bonus at the very last one, as long as no one else sees them. The concealment is very, very strong. It's very unfortunate it's tagged within the zone and hit and run. If you wanted to go different scouts, you could do, let's say, an in the zone scout, and you could go into lone wolf, ranger, aggression, in the zone, bring them on, bottom point targeting, you can just go full on damage. Or you can go a utility scout with hit and run and flush and low profile and hollow targeting and sprinter and smoke and mirrors. You can basically just make them utility and running around and doing whatever you need them to do. There's multiple builds you can do with scouts, but I more or less stay to my hollow target, deadeye, early on babysitter into a battle scanner, concealment, mid-game, powerhouse scout into bring them on, VPT for massive concealment crit marksman rifle shots later on. It kind of flows nicely along with the game as you go. That's pretty much the build I'm going to go for most of my scouts, unless I start specializing for some reason. But in the meantime, we need to figure out who are our scouts. Now, scouts have the second best aim progression in the game, but the worst health progression. So a scout with good health early on is very, very important. You'll see sometimes I'll take 3 health scouts, but that's because mobility and aim and defense and everything else about them is far more important. Generally, my scouts are not frontliners. They may draw overwatches, but beyond that, they shouldn't be involved in any shooting. They shouldn't be getting shot at. And if they are, I'm doing something wrong. I can promise you that. So I look for the mobility and the defense first. The health is a nice bonus. The aim needs to be more than average for me to be okay with it. Will is sort of an irrelevant factor when it comes to scouts, in my book. So we're looking at 15s. Defense can be -1. I'm okay with -1. -2 pushes it. But beyond that, no. 15's ideal, but I don't want a 3 health with negative defense. That in combination is just not good. Okay, I saw that's the only 15. You're an assault. You are not a scout, in fact. We are looking for other 14s with pretty good health. Owens could be it. Owens could absolutely be one. Who else could be one? You are a no. You're absolutely a no. You maybe, quite possibly could be it. You will likely be a Rocketeer when the day comes. No, no. I'm looking for 14s and 4 and see if there's any of them. 14 and 5, -166, that's feasible. That's feasible. That's acceptable. I'll take that. I will take that, in fact. I'm okay with this. I'm okay with that. That is acceptable. So now we are on to 13 in what we're looking for. This could be okay. That could be okay. 13 and what we're looking for. 13. No, that will be a engineer through and through. What are we? 13 and 4. 13 and 4. 13 and 4. 13 and 4. 69, -2. That's pushing it. That's pushing it. That's absolutely pushing it. We'll come back. We will come back to that. We'll see. We'll see. 13-4? No. 5? Okay. Now we're getting into 12s. Now, 12s, unless there is some stellar scout material here, I'm not going to consider a 12. And I don't recall that there is. By chance? No. 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 No, no, I already said no to you. No. Maybe. Quite possibly. We'll have to wait and see. No. So we're kind of in a jam here. Now, where was that 413? 413. I saw you somewhere. I saw you somewhere. There you are. That's a pretty good. The -2 is a bit unfortunate, but at the same time, that's pretty strong. The 69 is strong for us. And it is the 4, -2, -1, We're gonna go ahead and go with those. Who else are we going to be taking on as a scout? There was one other that was I was on the fence about, from my recollection. Not you. Not you. No, no, definitely no. Not 412. Not 412. Not 412. Not 412. Not 412. 414. Owens. Owens may be it. Owens may definitely be it. 65 is considered average. And Owens may be our gal. Yeah, Owens is our gal. Owens is the other scout. So this is not the best scouting group. This is not the best scouting bunch, in all blatant honesty. But I have seen worse. There have been worse. In addition to that, we're gonna go ahead and get our one sniper going, who needs to be a proper sniper, in all actuality. Now, negative 5 defense, this is gonna be something else for you. And low health. You're gonna be more or less in the back, carrying the med kit. You're not gonna be involved pretty much at any of these. You know what, we're gonna make you a pseudo-scout, as is. And by pseudo-scout, I mean not actually running Overwatches, I mean getting information and going where we need to go, and you're gonna hold the med kit. You should not be involved at all, which means we're gonna have to rely heavily on the rest of the squad, this squad specifically, to provide all the firepower that we need. And seeing as we have a good amount of firepower here, on top of the fact that we're gonna be carrying pretty much a lot of grenades, we should be okay. Everybody should be at 6 health base, which is the required minimum for combat, for combatants. I'm not going to consider you a combatant. You're going to be basically picking people up in the worst case scenarios. And that's about all you will be doing. Everybody else will be at least at 6 for minimum. Our gunners is at 9, which is great. Driz, you are at 7, which is also great. God, I can't even pronounce that. Is this what we want? Well, we could take out some other grenades. Go double grenades. There is no outsider. I'd rather have the cover destruction. We can remove that and just pick up kills as we go. If we run into that scenario. Yeah, I think the double grenades are better. I mean, 6 grenades across the entire squad, that's a good amount of cover destruction. It should benefit us as we need. I want... Who's mobile? Who's mobile? You're mobile. You're gonna go ahead and take care of... Well, you're at 66. You need the grenades. You're at... Never mind. You're at 66. You can take a flashbang. Or at least one flashbang. Just in case. You never know. You never know. You never know what may happen. You're gonna be a scout of scouts, I'll tell you that much. Whoops. Don't hit escape twice, apparently. That's bad news. That's bad news, bears. So, with an urban block, an idea of who we're going to be facing, a lot of explosives across the rookies, our two infamous babysitters, Driz and Splattercat, with our pseudo-scout SMG style. I'm going to change that. You're going to take a carbine. Carbine style, running around, murdering everybody. Yeah. Splattercat and Driz leading the charge. Let's take on our scouting mission, plus one sniper, and let's go ahead and roll into this ready to go. Let's go. It's not getting murdered. It's absolutely not getting murdered. That would be beneficial. Ideally, that would be strike one. All right. Listen up. So this is convenience.
Deep in the Nigerian interior for the next
This is going to be dependent on where we are.
Alien activity continues to surge within several major cities. Our response is crucial to minimizing the spread of panic.
All right, Central, thank you for the words of wisdom. As per usual, this is Operation Patient Paramore, led by Driz and Splattercat in tow with 3 scout future rookies and 1 sniper. We have a interesting map ahead of us. couple of rooftop straps we can get, varying on where we start. It's all going to be dependent on where Big Sky decides to drop us off. We're going to, we're going to hit the button, drop in. Let's roll out, people.
Autobots, roll out.
Cutscene every time. It's a great cutscene.
Central, this is Big
All right.
Strike team is touching down.
So this changes things.
Roger, Big Sky.
Or makes things a little bit easier for us, depending on how you want to look at it. Now, what this spawn more or less does is says, hey, this room, you can take this room. I would say don't take this room. This room is tempting, but not one of the best spots to be in. What it does give us access to is immediately to a free pipe to the roof. Now, this is a heavy. I'm going to wager there's a squad up here. So our first move is going to get everybody to here ready to go. Second move is going to be a motion tracker. Find out what's up here and where they are and move into position and go from there. With the amount of explosives we have, our gunner won't be able to get involved on the step up. But with who we have, we should be able to clear that pod and have no retaliation if we're smart about how we do it. So we're going to go to the roof, claim the roof. From there, we're going to overwatch this alley and Alt-O our way to victory. We have very little sightline here. If they do engage, though, we can scoot over, drop grenades, basically cause mayhem. We're going to control this alleyway, which should be a main funnel point. They don't have much cover, and if they do, we can destroy it. Main point, we're getting to this roof, and we are rolling with it pretty quickly. Using this pipe, not this pipe. I would rather engage them from here or murder all their cover. That's the best case scenario. Yeah, with that being said, let's go ahead and just start this little operation of ours, starting with our pseudo-scout. I'm going to step up to here, verify this room is clear, which it is, and then everybody's going to join up. Including our gunner. On a blue move, just in case. Just in case we pop something as silly as that is. Everybody else, move together.
Okay.
Alright. Roll the turn. Roll the turn. See what we hear. Sectoids. Sectoids. Drones. I think we're actually being accurately paid today. It may be the case. Alright. So, they are either right out here, or they're on the roof. These guys are probably right in here, I would say. Or they may be up here. Either way, this is something we need to take. This is something we prepare to take. This is something we are going to take. Now, we could cheese our way out a... tile scan. It's a little bit cheating, but, you know, you gotta use what you got. No, it seems like there's nobody active on that roof, so we're gonna go ahead and claim the roof.
Affirmative.
See what's up here. Absolutely nothing. What we do get, in fact, is a good description of all the pods. Now, there is a pod in this alleyway. There's a pod, I would wager, out here. And drones probably out here, or maybe somewhere here and here and here. Point is, one pod's probably hiding. We will step and see two pods immediately. So we're going to be very careful about how we step. We're going to step to the corner here.
Moving to position.
And have everybody join up as far as possible. Roger, now, we're going to take a couple turns to get there. So we will have a few sound vectors to get before we officially make our move onto that group down there.
On the move.
Now, being on the rooftop, we have the advantage. We can more or less control how we engage pretty much the entire time. As long as we are more or less smart about it, we'll also get a nice vector of what actually that is. I think that's sectoids, and they may be moving. Alright, Meld is down there. Have the gunner move to here. And then from here, we're going to have everybody ready to go onto the roof. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to take these 5 spots with the rookies. And from there, we're going to not be there. We're going to control the roof.
That's affirmative.
Basically.
Je vais vers la position.
Position confirmed.
And that is how we're going to manage this one. We're likely going to motion scan her next turn just to be sure that the pods haven't merged and we're not going to activate three pods simultaneously. Be very safe. I'd rather go home with no motion scanners than wounds. So the pods have merged. Now the question is, how bad of a merge is it? Now... pods are right there. Now we can see them from the tile scanning. That's not an object. These are the pods. Question is then, how far are they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Now we could cheese it. Take a spot down here, which will not activate them. Shouldn't activate them. I said will not, it shouldn't. But at this point, I'd rather let those pods disperse than anything else, so I'm going to let the turns roll. We're probably going to lose the meld, but at this point, that's okay. That's better than everything else that could happen. We're going to do one more turn roll. I think that pod has now come back to us. Yes, pods are right there. Good. So, nope.
Enemy in sight.
Well, I balls that up. And that's misclicks, everybody. Now we're in a scenario where we must murder everything, pretty much. This turn, non-negotiable. Question is, how are we going to do that? Now, we have a couple choices here. Wow, I royally balls that up. We have two here. The opportunity for infantry to just jump down here and not activate anything ideally and murder that sectoid. Yes. That's that play. Nope, we activated the drones. Alright, hopefully the drones will fly up. Give the gunner a nice big shot. Nope, alright. Gunner's gonna have to go down there eventually. In the meantime, that much has to happen. Can we be flanked? I don't think so, but we're not in a good way. But either way, this much has to happen. Every time. Alright, this changes things. Owens, first and foremost. Who has the best aim? You have the best aim, don't you? No, 66, 69, 65. Now, where can you get? That's good. Nowhere. Other than maybe, not even there. You can't even, wow. Well, that is something. Let's see how you do after these individuals move around. So that's a drop down here. That's a... Ooh, good. She can. He's gonna have to move back. And that sectoid's gonna have to be killed by somebody. Somehow. With you having the best aim, I would like you to drop down to here.
Moving out.
We're gonna have to see how this one goes. All stems off a mistake click and having to adjust to that accordingly. '97, '69, '66. Do you have a range bonus? No, you do. You have 1%. '92. That much has to happen. That much has to happen. Good.
Target eliminated.
Then, from here, we can clean up the sectoid. in a perfect world. What may be better is accepting damage, flashbanging, and being in a good position to not be killed by drones. Because we go here, we'll be flanked. Probably is the better position. You need to get out of dodge very, very quickly.
On my way.
That is your play. Now, what does that result in you doing? Oh, nope, Splattercat's here.
Roger that.
Salazar, you're here, which gives you multiple options. Now, we could flashbang. Reduce his aim to almost nothing. That'd be about a 15% shot, somewhere in that neighborhood. Because that's a minus 30 aim from that, about minus 29 or so from Red Fog. Not 29, like 25. Or we could murder you, but at the same time we'd be risking DR happening. And blowing up cover on Splattercat. I think the flashbang is better in this play. An AP would be actually bad. Actually, no, an AP would work. We could put it here and it would still kill it. An AP would be good, but we don't bring APs normally. I think flashbang is the play. Reduce his aim to almost nothing, even though he's point blank. Still take damage. Now, we could cheese out an HE grenade. But that's cheesing out an HE grenade. Do I want to do that? No, I'd rather have an HE grenade right on top of the idiot. At the same time, I can't justify just leaving him there. That range bonus is too much for me. See how close we can get it without ruining everything. Alright, I think that's as good as we're going to get. Let me edge it up to our infantry. Alright. RNGesus, praise. RNGesus, praise. No DR. Good. Perfect. It's about as good as we're going to get. You have no shot. Go ahead and wait. Maybe they'll shoot you. That flank is unfortunate, but we can deal with it. We can regroup as long as these drones don't flank us right now. That one may be able to get a flank on us. This is the worrisome part of the mission. What is this going to do? Alright, derp derp. Drones don't overwatch. What does the last one do? I think derp. Yep, it derps. Perfect. So other than 142% shot, it's about as good as we're going to get. In the meantime, Driz, we're going to have you drop back. The rookie. This is just an odd position. Now, we have to be smart about who we're suppressing here. Now, and where we're suppressing. Can you get on the roof? Yes, you can. Not to a good position. I'd rather have you be here. In all blatant honesty. Alright. We need... because I don't think they can go over this way. Or they can. But I just don't know. We need suppression onto you. And then we need everybody else to get up top who can. Very, very quickly. And not be basically useless. You're good there, honey. You're good stepping up here.
Let's do this.
Fiobla. You have no shots, so you instead overwatch. We're not. We do a couple of bad things. We're gonna go ahead and shoot at you. I say that, I mean that. We're gonna go ahead and shoot at you. Which leaves two moves left for us. We're gonna go ahead and reload and suppress the nearest one. Make that other drone have to fly. If it wants to flank at all. Now, things have blown up. What has blown up? Alright, drones are gonna derp. That's one derp. We need three derps. This is not a derp. This is not going to be a derp. This is going to be a flank. No, this is a derp. It's a half derp. It's a half derp. It's somewhere around the neighborhood of 2.5. That was 2.5, so 2.5 derps. Now we can kind of adjust ourselves to it. The drone being right in our face, that should be Drizzt's job right now to take care of that. Again, this should be Drizzt's job to take care of this drone right now. Good, we should be able to catch that up with our rookie to get a kill. Good, rookie gets a kill. Rookie gets a promotion, which is perfect for our circumstances. Now, Owens. After Salzahar basically, are all the rookies promoted? Yes, so now we just have to murder everything and we'd be good. Fiova, you're gonna go ahead and start laying into that drone. Best case scenario.
No way.
Salzahar, I'm gonna go ahead and lay into this drone. Best case scenario. Into Splattercat. Express that drone. Best case scenario. We're gonna have to wait and see. Owens, you should be actually good to... I don't think that drone can get a flank on you. We can actually make you relevant then. Yeah, that should be fine.
Aye, aye.
Which will get you two shots. Because that can't be flanked. Not that easily. Yeah. That gets you two shots. And this is just basically volume of fire, what we need to kill them, sort of thing. This drone on the wide is going to be an issue. I'll say that much right now. He's going to be an issue. He's going to continually go for a flank until he can get it. And that's an issue for us. Because there's not much we can do about that. Other than maybe murder him. But even then. Now what we could start doing is cheesing out some grenades. I don't think that's what's going to be best case scenario here. What we need is that one to be gone. And Owens, I don't think you're going anywhere. At least that's not the plan. Yeah, the drone could probably get a flank on you by now, but right now you're stuck here shooting at this dumb thing.
Adjusting aim.
Drizzt, I need you to connect. You're letting me down hard. These are why drones become issues. A step down to here may be the better choice. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Still probably gonna flank. What may be better is stepping down to here and forcing him just to step to us. Because at present moment, there's not much we can do. At present moment. That may be the better of the moves. Is just stepping down to here and dealing with him a little bit. Waiting and seeing, basically. You're not going to...
Ready to engage.
Suppress. Please, you're going to reload. You're going to suppress. Now, we could cheese the AI a little bit. If we get that drone to step closer, that would be interesting. Because if we could suppress this drone, keep him at bay, and get a nice hypersonic shot onto that specific drone, and roll the mission that way. It's going to be dependent on if it even moves, though. And it does, which is good. So that's a reaction shot for one. He's going to miss. I'm hedging my bets on the fact that he can't get a flank. Or the fact that he can, and I just did a big mistake. Alright. So that was a mistake. Drones can get that close. But it plays out to our advantage. Now that drone's up there. Which we are going to both confirm and then deny. Good. You're out of ammo. You're not... Okay, that's a bug. That is absolutely a bug. Sweet. Drones on the ground. We're gonna punish the drone. Hard. Murder that one, punish this one. Golden. This is a bug. This is a bug we should be aware of. This is a bug that needs to be fixed. It's pressing into from full cover into that's just a bug. Alrighty. You're not gonna be shooting anyways. So go ahead and take that pistol. The pistol could do it. I'm not saying the pistol will. But I am saying the pistol could. Into step and reload.
Moving.
Since we have to move anyways. Go ahead, get a shift. Or not even. We could also just not even. We could go boom boom. No, we need to kill it. We absolutely need to kill it. We may have to cheese line of sight to do it. Or we can absolutely kill it. Alright, so that's 100%. Drone being on the ground. Best case scenario. Omega, you could do it and then make this mission very simple for us. Not saying you would do it, though. Okay.
Ah, shit!
So then, how do we deal with the drone? Well, best response is to go here, cheese line of sight, and play the odds.
Okay.
And right now, that is the choice. We're already in a flank position anyways. If we don't get rid of the drone, it's going to hurt somebody. That's just the nature of the beast. So go ahead, murder that drone. Put rookies where we can see that drone coming in. Hopefully Overwatch, and see what we can get out of it. That's fine. Drone still shouldn't be able to see that rookie through the full cover line of sight blocking. Nope, we're perfect. Plays out exactly as planned. Which leaves us no suppression to deal, but a nice juicy target to hit from multiple perspectives. We're gonna lead off with Driz taking both of his shots. Where all the rookies are promoted, I don't really care about promotions at this point. Right now, I care about removing this drone from the grid to stop being an issue. A saw would be much more valuable at this point right now. Now, where are the other pods? Are we okay to step up?
Solid copy.
This is something I'm wanting to check. That answer is yes. We can step. Just a little bit. So this drone needs to be gone. Period. Because if we don't this turn, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is flankable. Drone needs to be gone. Period. Not negotiable. And you're out of ammo this turn. Could have dropped a grenade if I hadn't moved my soldier there right now. Drone has to be gone.
Heading there now.
Pistol could come in handy here. At a 71% chance to hit, that's not ideal. A better move maybe to move down. Step here, grab a reload, just let the drone crit somebody on a flank. No, someone's getting critted anyways, and he'll shoot her. And at 7 health, that is the best case scenario. We just gotta make sure Splattercat can get somewhere where we can suppress the next turn. Not really worry about it. I also get Splattercat there. Yeah. Because then Splattercat can shoot and deal damage this way. At this point, we're kind of just forcing our way up to it. And hoping it plays out. And that's basically all we have to throw at it. Tactically, it may not be the best choices. That grenade would have been better. I would feel a little more comfortable out of this shot. But right now, it's what we have to play with. It's what we have to use. And this drone's going to hurt somebody. But at this point, that's all we can do. Grab a reload and let's see what he does. Yep, there it goes. There's the crit. Again, part of the reason I give them 6 health, that wouldn't kill her no matter what. Even worst case scenario. So then, how do we manage? How do we manage? The Splattercat fire or suppress? Well, I think that question is, what do these do? If we suppress, it gives it a specific target. Salzahar, you're going to be in the medbay for a little bit. Are you the medic or the sniper? No, you're a... No, not even a medic. You're a scout. So you're going to be out for a while. And that's something we're going to have to deal with. Gunner's already going to be injured off that mission. This is not best case scenario. And we need to murder it now.
Moving.
Yeah, we need it to be gone now, not later.
Position confirmed.
Alright. Yes. You guys couldn't do that before.
Ready to rock.
Reload, reload. Overwatch the rest. We still have one more pod to deal with. That grenade would have been nice early on, but right now, we're kind of just licking our wounds and dealing with it. Let's go ahead and heal up our one rookie.
Oh, it's gonna hurt.
This is why we always adhere to the 2 med kit standard minimum.
Let's
grab a reload. Overwatch the rest. Wait for the turn. We'll get a vector and we'll deal with it. They are inside that building, I would wager. It's important that we get on the roof now and stop being exposed down here.
Solid copy.
Salzahar, I would like you to go next to our gunner, who's gonna heal you for the last little bit of damage. Make sure that you don't get murdered by something.
Come on, get back.
It's only 2, but Medkit only restores 3. Only restores 3. So, you know, kind of best case scenario thing. Reload our carbine.
Ready to engage.
And other than sitting on this ledge and waiting for them to walk into us, we will go ahead and start to hunt them down. It is the last pod. Yeah. So we are good to go, basically. We're good to go. Control the roof.
Time to motor.
Get a nice big sound vector from where they are. And we can roll with that.
Move, move, move!
For a second mission, that injury is going to hurt us a little bit. I need those scouts to babysit. The rest will do just fine, but I just need them to babysit a little bit more than they do. Now, they are more than likely... They're more likely than not in the street, which is something that we can easily check. Yes, they are right there. There's 3 of them. Let's not make the same mistake again. That basically put us in this way. Move over. Move over.
To position.
Shift. Shift everybody across the way.
Okay.
Boy.
Next turn we activate. Next turn we activate. They are right there. Now we can do some bad things to them. We can absolutely do some bad things to them. Owens at 13. Fiovla at 12. Who's a sniper, I think. Salazar? Owens. No, you're the sniper. You don't have anything, though. All right. Fiovla. Shift and grenade our buddies. Once we figure out where they are, specifically. There, right there, on the body. On the body. Grenade the body. Grenade the body? Yes, sir. But sir, it is a human. No, it is not. It is human no longer. Human is no longer is. There we go. Right there. Drop the grenade. Find out what they're doing. We'll be good. A little bit of damage spread out. We can activate. They don't know where we are. They scatter around. Best case scenario. Now comes in the cleanup crew. Omega. You can get some kills. As long as we can get... Where are you? You're there. Yes. Confirmed. Hi, boys. Yes. Salazar. Yes. I'm gonna save you, Owens, just in case. Everybody's promoted, right? Everybody who matters promoted. Splattercat, you will be promoted on your next mission. Otherwise, we are all good. All four rookies are, in fact, promoted. Right? Because you're promoted. Yeah. Probably should have checked that earlier. Here we go. One down.
Got him.
Two down. Three down. Mission.
Chalk up another one.
Whew. All right. Let's pack up bodies. Let's go home. That got ballsed up pretty quick. I'll say that much. I will, in fact, say that much. Alright. Wound for 22 days on Salazar. Wound for 8 days on Splattercat from fatigue. That's fine. Yeah. Operation Patient Paramore. Could have been worse. Could have been much worse. We could have had a terrible time on our hands, but we ended up with only a little bit of wounds. More or less from a misclick as a result of just not paying attention to what I was doing. This is a lesson that is good to be learned early on. Be very careful about who you click where more than anything else. What else do we have? That is 5 sectoid corpses, 4 drone wrecks, 4 illyrium, 4 alien alloys, 9 weapon fragments, and a meld. Operation Patient Paramore. Could have been worse. That's what I'm going to label it as. Could have been worse. Yeah. This has been Long War. Quest for Victory, Season 7. I have been Whittle. You have been you. It's been a good time. I feel good about this. If I stop doing silly things, I feel good about this. Yeah. So, yeah. Yep. 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 Yes. All right. Don't forget, everybody, to comment if you want one of these soldiers that was presented down below beforehand. Don't forget to, like, subscribe, follow, go check out Twitch. If you want a soldier and you're not enlisted in the Twitch, go to Twitch while I'm streaming and enlist a soldier. That's how you can be involved in Season 7. Please leave a comment. Just contact me through any means, being either a private message on either Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, a comment on YouTube, a tweet, whatever it is, get in contact with me, call out a soldier, you got him. And yeah, as I said before, this has been XCOM, I have been Whittle, you have been you, it has been a pleasure. Y'all stay safe out there, and I will see you in the next one.